There's a lot your iPhone can do, so these are the top 10 iPhone tips you should know. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today's iPhone tips are all about efficiency. So if you're ready to learn some iPhone tips and tricks you may not even know, then let's go. First up is live text. Now, you probably heard about live text when iOS 15 came out, but what is it really? Well, there are a couple of real-world practical applications of live text, including copying text from an image. So when you're in your camera app, you can just point your camera to any bit of text and wait for your iPhone to identify the text. You'll get yellow lines around the corner of the text on the screen, and you'll also have a little live text icon on the bottom right. Just tap on that icon to select the text. Now from here, you can copy the text to paste it into another application like Notes, for example. It's as easy as that. But that's not all you can do with live text. Oh no, you can also translate text. You're gonna start this process much the same way by using your camera to identify text, tapping on that live text option on the bottom right, but this time let's tap on the arrow to the right of our first three options, then tap on translate. And just like that, the text is translated. This trick works in a handful of languages right now, and yes, you can use live text from an already existing photo. So you don't always have to be taking the photo in order to do this. You can pull a photo right from your Photos app, and if there's readable text in it, your iPhone will provide you the same options. By the way, live text works on iPhone XS, XR or later, and iOS 15 or later. All right, hidden iPhone tip number two, scan and sign documents. Yes, just by using your iPhone and the built-in Notes app. This has gotten me out of a pinch, ooh, more than a time or two. So from a note, tap the camera button on the bottom and then tap on scan documents. Position the document you want to scan in view and the scan will automatically happen. Now, if there are multiple pages, you can continue to scan those in that same way, and then just tap on save in the bottom right whenever you're done scanning. And now your document is scanned. And now that your document is scanned, what if you need a signature on it? Well, no worries, you can do that too. Yes, really. All you have to do is tap on the document in the note, then tap on the share button, and from here, tap on markup. Then tap the plus button in the bottom right and tap on signature. Here you can add a saved signature or you can create a new signature. Once you're all done, you can adjust the size of the signature box and drag it to wherever you need it on the document. And then once you're all done all that, just tap on done. Your document is now signed. How neat is that? All right, iPhone tip number three, quickly share your location via text. You no longer have to go into Maps and drop a pin and then share that with someone. No. Instead, all you have to do from messages is type in, I'm at, and right here under your text bar is your current location. You can just tap on that and it will automatically send your location. This is so helpful if you're meeting friends or in a bind and need some help, or even if you want to just remember where you've parked your car. It's just great. And speaking of messages, you can pin content in messages. Again, this is for iOS 15 or later. So let's say you're sharing a lot of info in a convo thread. From that messages thread, tap and hold on the item you want to pin, and then tap on the pin option. So this pinned content is gonna be elevated in the detailed view of a conversation, in your messages search, and apps that support shared with you. So this makes it a heck of a lot easier to reference that item in the future. Coming in at number five, you can easily jump to the first photo in your Photos app. Yeah, instead of endlessly scrolling through to get back to the top of your photos, as if we all have that much time. So from your Photos app, tap on the top middle edge of your screen and blammo, you are taken right to the top of your photos, just like that. Now, if you want to quickly pop back down to your most recent photo, just tap on the library tab in the bottom left and you're instantly going to be popped back down. Hidden iPhone trick number 6 is to track your phone even when it's off. Yeah. So you know how you can use Find My to track your iPhone? Well, if you're extra like me and you even want to make sure it's being tracked while the device is off, you can do that too with just a quick settings change. So from the settings app, tap on your Apple ID at the top, then tap on Find My. Here at the top where it says Find My iPhone, tap on that. Now in this screen, you want to make sure all three options are toggled on, but specifically, it's the middle option here that says Find My Network. This is going to allow you to locate your iPhone even when it's off. Yes, please. Okay, iPhone tip number 7 has been a complete game changer for me when it comes to dragging and dropping and rearranging apps more efficiently. So the best way to describe what I'm saying is to show you what I mean, which, duh, this is a video and that's why you're here. So you know how typically when you want to move an app, you hold down on it and then drag it precariously to another screen and inevitably you go too far or it takes multiple attempts to just drop the app where you want it? Major frustration. Well, that's because we've been doing it wrong this whole time. Rather than trying to do it all with one hand, just hold on the app like you normally would, but use another finger on your other hand to swipe through your screens until you find where you want your app to go, and then drop it in place. I know, can you believe? Talk about a time saver and also just a sanity saver. But moving on to tip number 8, you can actually select multiple apps to move at once. So tap and hold on an app like you normally would, but this time, while you're still holding on that app, tap and hold on another app, and then another app, and as many apps as you want to move at once. They're all gonna be grouped together here, and you're gonna know how many you've selected based on the number in the top right of that app stack. Then you can just use that little secondhand swipe feature to swipe to the screen you want and drop multiple apps at once. Whoa. And speaking of doing multiple things at once, you can close multiple applications at once. That is, if you ever close your apps. Okay, so you know how if you tap and swipe from the bottom, you can swipe through all your open applications and then swipe up on an app to close it? Well, why waste time closing one at a time? You can actually close multiple apps at once. So here I have got 3 open apps on screen. I'm gonna take 3 fingers and rest them one over each app and then swipe up to close all 3 at once. Or say you want the ones on either end here closed, but not the one in the middle. We'll just swipe up on both and they are gone, but the middle one remains. I love me some swipe tips. So tip number 10 is to swipe to erase a digit in the calculator app. So let's just say you're a completely normal human being who accidentally entered the wrong digit into your calculator while completing an equation. Well, all you have to do is swipe left or right at the top of the screen to erase it. This will erase one digit at a time for you, so you can enter in the correct digit and continue on with your equation, rather than having to start all over. Amen. And if you've watched this far, you deserve a bonus tip for your time. So keeping in this swipe theme, you can also use this little trick in the Notes app to indent text. Here's what I mean. Let's say you're writing a checklist in Notes. Well, just swipe right on the bullet point line you want to indent. The more you swipe, the more indented it will be. And you can swipe left to move it back if you want. This works for these bullet points, by the way, but not the full text in the body of your notes. So if you want to learn even more iPhone tips and tricks, you can explore the links in the description below. Until then, happy swiping. So those are my picks for the 10 iPhone tips you should know. What do you think of these hidden iPhone features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for even more iPhone content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.